Hi, my name is Brittany Lombos. I'm at Terrebonne General. I'm a radiologic technologist. Most people know us as X-ray techs, and I've been here for about 5 years. So an X-ray tech is someone who takes pictures of internal structures of the body, soft tissue, bones, whatever it be. We do that using radiation and special equipment to create these images that help doctors diagnose and treat sick patients. I didn't always want to be an X-ray tech. I didn't realize that I did. I originally went to college for art. I was a photography and graphic design major at Nicholls State, and then eventually transitioned and became a cosmetologist. I worked as a cosmetologist for about 5 to 6 years, but I really wanted something with more consistency, and I wanted a better job security, and I wanted something that would be better for me and my schedule for my family. My sister and I had a conversation. She works in radiology, and she told me about X-ray and how great the schedule was and how consistent it was and the job security. And she told me basically about how we were the photographers of the medical world. And ever since then, I was hooked. So even though I started as an art major in school, I do feel like that crossed over a lot into the radiology field. There's a lot of times we deal with difficult patients or patients who can't necessarily move the way we'd like them to. And you have to get very creative to be able to achieve optimal images for these doctors to make the best diagnosis of these patients. So to become an X-ray technologist, you have to attend a college or university depending on what you want to do with it. You could start out with an associate's in applied science. I went to Delgado Community College here in New Orleans and got my associate's there. It's basically about a year and a half to 2 years of prerequisites of your core classes, your sciences, and then after that, it's 2 complete years of clinicals where you're located at one site. I was here at TGMC for my complete 2 years, and it really let me get to know the hospital and get to know a lot more about X-ray in the field. A lot of people, after they graduate with their associates, do go on to get their bachelor's degrees if they want to branch out into management, or if they wanted to teach, or if they wanted to do any of those things, they can. And also, you can also get extra certifications. So you start out in X-ray, and if you wanted to, you could become an MRI tech, or you could do CT or ultrasound, or you could really change your modality. There's a lot of room to grow in this X-ray field. The main subject that you definitely should focus on is biology. We're working with structures of the body. You need to know a complete anatomy of the human body. So biology is definitely gonna be your number one focus if you do like the X-ray field. Also, we do a little bit of math in school and a little bit of physics in school, because you're learning about radiation and doses and how to keep your patients the safest you possibly can. And there is a little bit of math involved with that. So X-ray for me is rewarding because, for one, I mean, you're a photographer. You're taking really, really great images. And if you know that your images are gonna help a patient who might not be feeling so well, or, you know, might be in pain, and you know that these images are gonna help the doctor to better tell them what's going on, you take a lot of pride in that, and a lot of pride in your images and how you achieve them. Also, just patient care in general. If you like helping people, if you like making people feel comfortable, I'm a very social person. So for me, when patients come in and you can tell that they're super nervous, or, you know, don't really feel comfortable, or maybe they're upset about some bad news they recently had, if you can make them feel more comfortable in that process, that's, you know, really, really rewarding. For me, the most challenging part of X-ray is, you know, dealing with not ideal situations or things that some people think their stomach can't handle in certain times. You know, you're working in a hospital, you're seeing different type of situations every single day. Not every patient's gonna be easy, but at the same time, working in a hospital, we have a big team in our radiology department, and we always help each other, whether it's, you know, using muscles to get a patient onto the table and everyone helping lift their share, or anything. You know, we really work as a team to make sure everybody has the least amount of stress they can for the day. So you definitely can't expect to get rich being an X-ray tech, but you do live pretty comfortably. So depending on what modality you decide to work in and your years of experience, your range of salary is really large and really depending on what you want to make out of it. You can make a very comfortable second income, you know, for your family, or you could be a primary breadwinner depending on how far you'd like to go in the field. So my advice for you, if you want to go into the x-ray field, is definitely do a little bit of volunteer time. Talk to your local hospitals, talk to different departments, and ask them if you can go in and job shadow. And then you can see what the daily responsibilities are or the atmosphere and see if it's really for you. Also, if you do decide to go to college for radiology, our hospital for sure does what's called a tech assistant program. So we hire you as a tech assistant where you can come in and it's basically like job shadowing the technologist, and you really get to do extra practice while you're in college so you can master your skills. But also TGMC has now, what they do is tuition reimbursement. So if you decide to be a tech assistant here at TGMC, they'll actually reimburse you for your tuition with the agreement, you know, that you would work here afterwards. But it gets really good experience. It lets you practice your skill a whole lot more and really perfect what you want to do.